Good afternoon, class of 2024, faculty and staff, friends and family of the University and the Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health. Dr. Gevitz and Dean McLeod, it is my honor and privilege to present to you the class of 2024 for their white coat ceremony.
Thank you, Ms. Haxton. Good afternoon, everyone. You may be seated. Welcome, Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health, class of 2024. Welcome to all family and friends. I am Dr. Dwight McLeod, Dean of the Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health. We are so happy to have you here today. At this time, I would like to introduce to you those seated directly behind me. If you would, please hold your applause until the end of the introductions. Beginning on my immediate right, Dr. Norman Gavitz, Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, A.T. Still University. Ms. Laurie Haxton, Vice President for Student Affairs, A.T. Still University. On my immediate left, Ms. Madison Williams, Past President, Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health, Student Government Association, and member of the class of 2023. Seated with the class of 2024 is Mr. Jacob Palmer, class of 2024 president, who you will meet during the key transfer. Also with us today are Dr. Alan Freeman, CEO and president of our partner, Affinia Healthcare, and Dr. Robert Tate, president of the Missouri Dental Association. Last but certainly not least, I would like to acknowledge our faculty. At this time, Dr. Norman Gavitz, Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, will share some remarks. Dr. Gavitz.
Thank you, Dr. McLeod. The world's first dental college was established in Baltimore, Maryland in 1840. Its graduates received the DDS, or Doctor of Dental Surgery, degree. Prior to the creation of this school, all college-educated dental practitioners in Europe and the United States held the MD degree or its equivalent. In 1867, Harvard University established its dental college side by side with its medical school, and many dental students stayed at Harvard to attend and graduate from both schools. Instead of a DDS degree, Harvard awarded a Doctor of Dental Medicine degree, or DMD, to signify that its graduates were trained as physicians of the oral cavity and its adjacent structures. The DMD degree is the degree MOSDOH will award you when you complete your curricular requirements. As the 20th century unfolded, American medical schools and dental schools lengthened their undergraduate curriculum, and consequently, the desire to attend and graduate from two schools and obtaining two separate degrees diminished. The ensuing professional separation of medicine from dentistry has raised questions about the domains and divisions of knowledge and comparative scope of practice regarding the oral cavity and its adjacent tissues. Where are the overlaps and divisions between the dental and medical practitioner? What challenges are there in defining and delineating scope of knowledge, scope of practice, and licensure? Which practitioner is competent to do what? Most importantly, how do all these questions impact access to quality and cost of healthcare? At ATSU, we love to innovate, and we can bring different health professions together in our state-of-the-art simulation labs, in joint teaching, and in team-based problem solving, both here and in community health centers, to enrich you, your DO student counterparts, and other health professionals in training to produce distinctive, collaboration-ready practitioners. Your white coat is not only representative of the beginning of your professional journey, but ATSU's commitment to educate the most broadly prepared and qualified dentists in the United States. You have entrusted yourselves to us, and ATSU is surely committed to you. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Gavitz. At this time, it is my pleasure to welcome Ms. Madison Williams. Ms. Williams is the past president of the Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health Student Government Association and a member of the class of 2023. Ms. Williams is a graduate of the University of Missouri. Ms. Madison.
Dr. McLeod. Though it has now been over a year since you received it, I'm sure everyone here remembers getting their acceptance call into MOSDOH. It's a day you'll never forget, as I'll surely never forget mine. It was February 27th, 2019, while I was working as a dental assistant. I was holding an upper denture in place for a soft reline when I felt my watch buzz and recognize the Kirksville area code. It's a good thing the setup time was over, because I don't think I've ever left a room more quickly. This was the easiest yes I've ever said, and to this day, the best decision I've ever made. You all have had the unique experience to have spent one full year in Kirksville prior to today, and I hope that today you still feel the same way you did when you first arrived. Usually I'd be here to welcome you to the community, but you've since had the privilege to be immersed in it, in a slightly different way, however. I commend you for doing the absolute hardest thing that you will ever do during the absolute hardest time that you could ever do it. Going through your first year of dental school during a pandemic made many aspects more than difficult for you, yet here you stand. Online dental school was probably something that you never wanted to do, but you did it. Asking questions to professors over Zoom while everyone, or maybe no one, is listening, is probably something that you never wanted to do, but you did it. Figuring out how to make friends without even being able to meet anyone is probably something that you never wanted to do, but you did it. Taking block exams that cover information that you swear you've never heard is probably something that you never wanted to do, but you did it, and here you stand. You wouldn't have gotten that acceptance call, and you wouldn't be here today if you didn't deserve it and if you didn't earn it. You have worked for this. Speaking from the viewpoint of a new D3, my advice to you is to live in the now. It's difficult to not be worried about tomorrow, next week's exam, and even next year's move, but take advantage of what you have right here, right now. This means thoroughly enjoying the privilege that is standing in line to get feedback on a prep for 10 minutes just to hear that it needs to be extended by 0.25 millimeters. Everything that you have done in all of your yesterdays prepares you for all of your tomorrows, and when the time comes to transition, you will be ready. But focus on right now. Continue to take things one day at a time. Remember to ask for help when you need it. Stay true to yourself and find strength in working as a team, because as we know and as we believe, collaboration leads to better quality, whole person healthcare, and to more simply put it, teamwork makes the dream work.
Thank you, Ms. Williams. Congratulations to you, class of 2024. You're the chosen ones from an application pool of 1,365 applications. The class of 2024 comprises 29 females and 35 males, and within the group, there are 7 underrepresented minorities. The average age is 24. 20 states are represented, and 10 students are from Missouri. Additionally, the other top states represented are as follows: 11 students from Illinois, 10 students from Texas, 5 from Arkansas, 4 from California, and 3 from Michigan. Members of the class of 2024, you entered the Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health in the middle of a pandemic. Our traditional pomp and circumstance around your arrival did not happen in the traditional manner because of CDC guidelines and AT Still University's proactiveness to keep everyone safe. Social media was the only way you could really connect with your classmates for several months. You entered an academic experience that was new to you, and without a doubt, far more challenging than any other educational experiences you ever have had. As a class, you demonstrated resilience and stamina. You did not waver in your tenacity to succeed, even in the midst of all the chaos, unknown, and difficulties that were occurring around you and in our nation as you learned remotely. You mastered the most rigorous year of dental school, in which all of us can unanimously agree is perhaps the toughest period of your young lives. Your journey thus far has not been easy. I encourage you to continue to persevere, remain focused, and stay the course. As a D1 student, you have experienced excitement, varying emotions, disappointments, achievements, transformations, new relationships, and accomplishments. Your D2 year is off to a great start, and you are now able to provide guidance and mentorship to your new peers, the members of the class of 2025. In the end, the most rewarding achievement will be successful completion of the academic program at the close of 4 years. The best stories you will have to tell are the friendships that you have formed and the memories you will have of the staff, professors, and your classmates. Your tenure in dental school will be some of the very best years of your life. To your parents, relatives, loved ones, and supporters, we thank you for entrusting your daughter or son to us for the transformation from student to dentist. We're delivering on our promise to provide a contemporary, innovative, and first-class education that will result in the culmination of the coveted Doctor of Dental Medicine degree. Your new graduate will experience a culture that is resulting in a more compassionate, caring, and community service-oriented professional who is embracing dentistry and whole person health. Your son or daughter is currently experiencing more essential early clinical experiences, and in the upcoming year, your experience will be more robust regarding interprofessional education and interprofessional collaborative care, special needs dentistry, hospital rotations, special needs dentistry community outreach events, interaction with periodontal and endodontic residents, teledentistry, more required and elective educational offerings, including leadership courses, in-state dental missions, more local clinical rotations, and new Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health programs and initiatives. Thank you so much for giving the Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health the opportunity to fulfill your loved one's dreams in the well-embraced osteopathic tradition of A.T. Still University. So today is your white coat ceremony. It is a special day to celebrate a new beginning. The white coat you will receive today symbolizes different things to different people. Some of your relatives and friends who are present, as well as your future patients, will view the wearer of a white coat as having knowledge to heal and improve the well-being and overall health status of those you will serve. Others may view the wearer as someone who is a colleague and partner in managing the oral health care needs of individuals as well as the health care needs of communities. To others, the white coat may symbolize an accomplishment, such as the successful completion of dental school. Whatever one's perception is of the white coat, keep in mind that as an oral health professional, you will have the opportunity to influence that perception. Class of 2024, this is your modified traditional white coat ceremony. It was well worth the wait, and we are thrilled that you will experience this induction into the dental profession. This is the day you begin your journey as a career dentist. I wish you continued success, good luck, and best wishes. At this time, I would like to welcome the class of 2024 to the stage. Will the first row please stand? We do ask you to hold your applause until all students have crossed the stage.
Hello, my name is Sinharib Imara. I went to University of Missouri, St. Louis. I have a bachelor's degree in biochemistry, biotechnology. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Chantel Eklund. I went to Washington State University and got a bachelor's of science in biochemistry.
Hello, my name is Parisa Ibrahimi, and I went to University of Houston and got a bachelor's in public health.
Hello, my name is Chris Eastburn, and I attended Arkansas Tech University, where I got a bachelor's in biomedical biology and a master's in business administration.
Hello, my name is Taylor Cecil. I attended Maryville University, St. Louis, where I received my bachelor's in biology.
Hello, my name is Hung Bui, and I went to California State University, Fullerton, where I got my bachelor's in biology, and I also went to USC for my master's of science in global medicine.
Good afternoon. My name is Ashley Brown. I attended the University of Kentucky, and I got my degree in medical biotechnology.
Hello, my name is Tanner Adams. I attended Prairie View A&M University, where I got a bachelor in biology.
Hello, my name is Riyam Abdul Wahab. I graduated from the University of Houston with a major in biology.
Hello, my name is Jacob Palmer. I graduated from Southeast Missouri State University with a degree in psychology.
Hello, my name is Nick Haste. I went to Indiana University with a degree in informatics.
Hello, my name is John Hadsma, and I graduated from Michigan State University with a degree in physiology.
Hello, my name is Marissa Gardner. I graduated from Northern Michigan University, and I graduated with a biochemistry degree.
Hello, I'm Matt Gallup. I did my undergraduate in Brigham Young University, Idaho, where I received my bachelor in biology.
Hello, I'm Kennedy French. I am from Columbus, Kansas. I went to Missouri Southern State University, and I got a degree in biology.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Roman Fratesi. I went to the University of Arkansas and got a BA in biology and a Master's of Biomedical Science from the University of Mississippi Medical Center.
Hello, I'm Jaron Francis, and I graduated from the University of Houston with a nutritional sciences degree.
Hello, I'm Rachel Faulkner. I graduated from the University of Arkansas with a degree in biology.
Hello, my name is Katie Fobel. I went to the University of Missouri, Columbia, and got a bachelor's degree in biology, and I got my master's degree in biomedical sciences from the Kirksville College of Osteopathic Medicine.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Yesenia Enriquez. I graduated from George Mason University in Northern Virginia, and I majored in biology.
Hello, everyone. I'm Ryan Merritt, and
I graduated from the University of Missouri Columbia and got a degree in health science.
Hi, my name is Lily McQuay. I graduated from Arkansas State University and I got a degree in biology.
Hello everyone, I'm Frank McGinnis. I went to the University of Kansas for a Bachelor's of General Studies and Fort Hays State University for a Master's in Public Health Administration.
Hello, my name is Pedro Majwile with a diploma from Las Lomas High School.
Hi, my name is Kimberly Coors. I went to the University of Tulsa where I received my bachelor's in exercise and sports science.
Hi, my name is Faisal Khan. I attended Benedictine University with a degree in health sciences.
Hello everyone, I'm Nicole Karras. I graduated from the University of Minnesota Twin Cities with a degree in physiology.
Good afternoon everyone, my name is Jack Joe Kane. I graduated from the University of Missouri Columbia with a degree in biological science.
Hello everyone. My name is Bijan Jamshidi, and I have a degree in kinesiology and biotechnology from the University of Alabama at Birmingham.
Hello, everybody. My name is Patrick Horning. I attended Drury University, and I graduated with a degree in biology.
Hello, my name is Jairus Burpo. I went to the University of Arkansas, and I got a degree in biology.
Hello everyone, I'm Raj Patel. I went to Texas A&M University and got a degree in biomedical science. Giga.
My name is Payal Patel and I graduated from the University of Oklahoma with a degree in biology.
Hi, I'm Nikki Patel. I graduated from the University of Tennessee at Chattanooga with a degree in biology.
Hi, my name is Nikita Patel. I went to University of Houston with a degree in biology.
Hello, everyone. I'm Neil Patel. I went to University of Illinois Chicago, where I graduated with the Exercise Science and Nutrition degree.
Good afternoon. My name is Tyler Olson. I went to Central College in Pella, Iowa, where I received a degree in biology, and then I went on to Iowa State and got a master's in biomedical sciences.
Hello, my name is Nasheen Nizamuddin. I graduated from Wayne State University and I got a bachelor's in nutrition and food science.
Hello, hello. My name is Dakon Jennifer Nguyen. I came from University of St. Thomas and I have a bachelor of biology.
Hello, everyone. My name is Josh Newman, and I attended Shrine University and graduated with a degree in biology health science.
Hey, guys. My name is Destiny Mills. I graduated from Arizona State University with a bachelor's in interdisciplinary studies with concentrations of biochemistry and business marketing.
Hi, everyone. My name is Nicole Silvers, and I attended Rockford University and majored in biology.
Hello. My name is Glenn Sigler. I attended Pittsburgh State University and graduated with a degree in biology.
Hello. My name is Chi Hyuk So, and I graduated from University of California, Los Angeles, with degree of biology.
Hello, everyone. My name is Adrian Salinas, and I graduated from the University of Texas in San Antonio with a degree in biology, and I also did a master's of biomedical sciences at Incarnate Word University in San Antonio.
Hello, my name is Sonia Sajid. I graduated from the University of Michigan with a degree in psychology.
Hello, my name is Eric Grube. I graduated from Illinois College with a bachelor's in biology and from Midwestern Downers Grove with a master's of arts in biomedical science.
Hi, my name is Katie Ruddle, and I graduated from Mississippi State University with a bachelor's of business management.
Hi, my name is Richa Renpura, and I graduated from Loyola University Chicago, where I received my bachelor's in biology.
Hello, my name is Tyler Pryor. I attended Fort Wayne, Indiana University Fort Wayne, and received a degree in dental technology.
Hello, everyone. My name is Tate Pearson, and I attended BYU Idaho and received a degree in public health.
Hi, my name is Taylor Rollman, and I graduated from North Carolina State with a degree in human bio.
Hi, my name is Tanya Wadwa, and I graduated from the University of Missouri, St. Louis with a degree in biology.
Hi, my name is Brian Vu. I graduated from the University of California, Irvine with a bachelor's in biological sciences.
Hi, my name is Stephanie Trevino. I graduated from Texas A&M University with a degree in nutritional science.
My name is Lamia Tanovic, and I have a biology degree from Loyola University, Chicago.
Good afternoon. My name is Simon Tadros. I graduated from Governor State University in Madison, Illinois, in a degree in public health.
Hello, everyone. I am Tyler Stidham. I graduated from Shawnee State University with a degree in biomedical science.
Hi, my name is Caroline Stark, and I graduated from Auburn University with a degree in biomedical science.
Hello, I'm Taylor Spear. I graduated from the University of Minnesota Crookston with a degree in health sciences.
Hello, my name's Hunter Irwin. I graduated from Xavier University with a degree in biology, and then Iowa State University with a master's in biomedical sciences.
Hello, my name's Hunter Jones. I graduated from Ouachita State University, and I got a degree in biology.
Will the class of 2024 rise and join me in reciting the oath to the profession located on page 6 of your program? I pledge to faithfully fulfill my obligations as a member of the dental profession. My responsibility is to promote the health of the community and the persons I serve. The health of my patients will be my first commitment. My practice depends upon the trust of my patients. I will not violate that trust. I will do no harm. I will honor my peers and respect the diversity they bring to the profession and commit to our mutual success. I will honor my patients' dignity. I will be their zealous advocate, sensitive to their feelings, needs, and thoughts. I will not discriminate against any person in my decisions and care. I will recognize the limit of my competence. I will seek knowledge and inspiration from my colleagues whenever my patients' needs require. I will strive to improve my knowledge and skills. I am responsible for contributing to the improvement of the community. I will strive to prevent disease and correct adverse social conditions. I will serve as both a teacher and role model for my patients, my successors, and the public. I am responsible for upholding my profession's integrity. I will strive to counsel those deficient in character or competence and expose those who engage in fraud or deception. I will use my professional knowledge according to the laws of humanity. With this oath, I willingly assume these responsibilities. Thank you. You may be seated. At this time, I would like to welcome Ms. Laurie Hackson, ATSU University Vice President of Student Affairs, back to the podium. Ms. Hackson.
Thank you, Dr. McLeod. For 72 years, the key transfer ceremony has been held at ATSU to demonstrate the willingness and commitment of the current students to reach out and to support the new class of students. The key is symbolic of our founder, A.T. Still's birthplace cabin, and the ceremony is symbolic of the rich heritage of each student and alumnus supporting those new to the dental profession and A.T. Still University. As is tradition, a representative of the class of 2023, Maddie Williams, will present the key to the class of 2024 member, Jacob Palmer, a graduate of Southeast Missouri State. Maddie, please come forward.
Thank you, Ms. Haxton. At this time, I would like to present the symbolic key to Jacob Palmer, president of ATSU-MOSDOH class of 2024. Jacob, accept this key for your class as a reminder to carry on the compassion and integrity for the profession of dentistry and A.T. Still University, MOSDOH School of Dentistry and Oral Health.
Thanks, Maddie. It is an honor to accept this key on behalf of the Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health, class of 2024. On behalf of my class, I would like to thank the faculty, staff, and students of ATSU for inviting us and our loved ones to join the ATSU MOSDOH family. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Palmer. Class of 2024, you are on a journey to complete one of the world's most respected degrees and to join one of the world's most respected professions. The professional oath you took today called for you to honor and uphold the profession with the highest regards. We're standing on the shoulders of those who have advanced dentistry through science, excellence in education, research, psychology, behavioral science, clinical practice, product development and application, and technology and innovation. Your obligation will be to advance, promote, and protect the profession while adhering to the moral commitment of just and fair treatment for all patients. There is strong advocacy by many stakeholders to integrate oral health care into primary care for the betterment of the overall health and well-being of the patients we serve. Many healthcare providers are now realizing that oral health can impact the overall systemic health and vice versa. Through research, dentists have known this connection for decades and have been advocating for integration. When we work collaboratively as healthcare professionals, the patients are the true beneficiaries. The outcome is clear. We end up with reductions in chronic diseases, leading to healthier people, communities, and a healthier United States of America. I hope as future dentists, you will lead that campaign, and as an A.T. Still University, Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health graduate, you will continue to embrace whole person health. We must always be grateful for the privilege to treat and heal and for the trust given to our patients and the communities we serve. Class of 2024, in less than 36 months, you will earn that honor. The White Coat Ceremony is made possible through the collaborative efforts of members of ATSU University and the Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health family. I would like to express my gratitude for the support given by President Craig Phelps and members from his office, the support given by the Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Norman Gavitt. Likewise, I'm thankful to Ms. Laurie Haxton and the members from her Office of Student Affairs, the innovative team from Information Technology, Mr. Dean Mogg, Mr. Corey Sanford, and other members, the dynamic team from Communications and Marketing, Mr. Sean O'Connors, Ms. Virginia Halterman, and Mr. Jason Hunsaker. The MOSDOH family, spearheaded by Ms. Kristen Blunk and her dynamic and supportive team, as well as administrators and faculty. Thanks to our guests, the families, friends, and loved ones of the class of 2024, and our 64 honorees from the class of 2024, and to everyone who participated in making this ceremony possible. Please join us for a reception honoring the class of 2024 in the IPE building immediately following the ceremony. The White Coat Ceremony is now concluded. On behalf of Missouri School of Dentistry and Oral Health Administration, faculty, and staff, I welcome and present to you the class of 2024.